Paige and I'm a Business Compliance Advisor for Environmental Health. For a lot of people, lockdowns change the way that they can run the business, so I'm going to go through some things for you to consider if you're thinking of starting a business up from home. The first and most important thing you need to consider is planning permission. Planning permission is not just for building extensions or garages, and whether or not you need it is assessed on a case-by-case basis. If you're running a business which frequently attracts people to your home, such as beauticians and hairdressers, personal trainers, food businesses or takeaways, it is likely that you're going to need planning permission. This is because if your business gets reported as a nuisance by a neighbour, which is something that we've seen a massive rise in throughout lockdown, you could be asked to apply for planning permission after you've already started trading, which will stop you from trading while you wait, causing you to lose customers and lose money too. Aside from checking with the planning department, some other things that you can consider are just keeping your neighbours in the loop about your business to reassure them that it's not going to cause any problems for them. You could also be mindful of noise from car doors or people in your garden or any equipment you're using, for example, and you could even consider staggering your appointments. Make sure that you've got enough space as well for any extra waste that you're producing so it doesn't look messy or attract any pests. And also think about where your customers are going to park. Make sure that there's enough space for them and they're not obstructing your neighbours and causing a nuisance. You could also think about the steps to legitimise your business. If it's a food business, then you must register and find out what the food safety requirements are and make sure you register 28 days before you want to start trading. Are there any health and safety requirements for the work that you're doing? You can find out at www.hse.gov.uk. Have you got public liability insurance? Remember that the level of cover you need depends on the risk level of your business. Are you employing any staff and do you need employer's liability insurance? Have you let your home insurance company know to avoid it affecting your policy, or have you let your landlord know? And will your business affect your taxes? Do you need to speak to HMRC? Whether or not you're trying to get back on your feet, or even if you just want a change after lockdown, we want to make sure that you get a fair chance at starting your business up and make sure you're getting the right support. If you want to check with the planning department, you can contact them via the council's contact centre. And for further guidance or training, contact business@wakefield.gov.uk.